Brian Kilmeade, Sam Houston, and the Alamo Avengers, the Texas victory that changed American history. We've talked to Brian before on his other books, and Brian has turned into such the historian because of his style of writing these books, and you watch him every morning on Fox and Friends as well. But I notice you're not there this morning, Brian.
But I'm going to be on the radio. So I do my radio show from 9 to noon Eastern time. So I'm in, I know if I want to get people that are passionate about history, I got to leave New York.
Yeah.
So I'm more than happy to go visit my affiliate here in Oklahoma, Tulsa, go to Oklahoma City, then over to Texas. Traveling all around, went to Dayton, went to South Bend. And I just get a lot of people who are passionate about our history, but we're busy. Everyone's got 90 different things to do on a daily basis. So I thought if I could boil down great moments in our past, it should get more attention. I found a lot of people who care about the news like to hear about these stories.
Well, and I love these books. You got George Washington's Secret Six, Thomas Jefferson, the Tripoli Pirates. That was my favorite right there. Andrew Jackson, The Miracle of New Orleans. Did you ever think that you would turn into quite the historian, writing these books in such a way that they can be devoured in a few settings?
No, not in a million years. I thought I'd just be a consumer and passionate about it. When I could put on the History Channel or put on some of those auxiliary channels that look back at our past, even though they got to be done with sketches and voiceovers as opposed to World War II with video, I've always been fascinated by it. And the other thing is, as all our listeners know, you could go feel our history. You can go to Virginia. You can go to Boston. You can go to New York. You can go to Texas. You can go to these places. And they're not just museums.
Yeah.
You could go back and stand where Sam Houston stood. You can go back and stand where Washington called home. And when I got that series on Fox Nation, What Made America Great, they asked me to do this series as almost a favor. And I said, really? I should be paying you.
Mm.
And when they sent me to the Alamo, I thought, well, this is going to be great for me. Everybody's been to the Alamo except me. And that was 3 years ago, two and a half years ago. Then I realized there's so much more to the story. I said, what if I told the story? We know the Alamo, okay, but I'll remind you. And then before that, what if I told what led to the Alamo? I'll go through that. And then what if I told you it wasn't the only massacre? There was one that was worse just a week later. And what if I told you how it ended? One of the most miraculous military victories in our history. And then tell you this is an American story, not a Texas story. I thought there might be an audience for it.
Oh, big time. And I'm so glad you wrote it. Sam Houston and the Alamo Avengers, the Texas victory that changed American history. I'll tell you, when I fell in love with this story, I grew up here, and I've been on the radio 45 years here. My dad was on the radio for 60 years, and he was an actor in Hollywood, was friends with John Wayne, so he was in the 1960 version of the Alamo, and he was the guard at Sam Houston's camp in San Jacinto when the dispatch went out there to let Sam Houston know what had happened at the Alamo, and the Alamo was falling. And that was Frankie Valli, Frankie Avalon, I'm sorry, that wrote out there. So that's when I fell in love with the story about Sam Houston and what happened at the Battle of San Jacinto and everything. And so, in a thumbnail here, because I know I don't have you all morning, in a thumbnail, give our listeners your take on that battle and what transpired.
Well, the weird thing is, and people in San Antonio know this, it's a little bit of a drive, but everyone goes to the Alamo, and they're reclaiming the footprint of the Alamo. At a time in which everything's retracting and we're running from our history, you guys are reclaiming it. How they build it, I know, is controversial, but in our TV special on Fox News, November 17th, our last block is with George P. Bush, and we see with you guys, I know it's a daily thing, with drumbeat with you guys, but around the country, they don't know. That the Alamo's going to push everything back and become more of an historical site. But at San Jacinto, you go there, and it's the biggest tower, bigger than the Washington Monument, and there's not enough people visiting. It is bigger than life, like everything in Texas. And the writings on the tower are significant as well. But you could go and stand exactly where Sam Houston stood. You could go exactly where his army was. Then we went over with Stephen Moore, who wrote 18 minutes. That's alone the victory took to officially ended in 2 hours, but in 18 minutes it was decisively won. You see where the Mexican army was. And you see the fact that with the slight incline in the high grass and the fact that Sam Houston decided to fight at 2 in the afternoon, which was unorthodox then, the night vision glasses hadn't arrived. In fact, they were 100 years in the future. So they had to fight during the day. So for him to attack in the afternoon, for the Mexican army to march all day to reinforce and need a rest, and for him to get up at 10, meet at 12, and then decide to fight at 2:30, that was a combination, that the high grass and the slight incline, managed this attack to be a surprise attack. And that was fortuitous because the Mexican army evidently also, when they went to rest, piled their guns. So by the time they got their guns, they had a choice. Go run for a gun and maybe get killed, or run for your lives and get killed anyway. And the fact that they captured Santa Anna a couple of days later, and instead of killing him, they sit there and they draw up a plan to get Texas and call off the reinforcements. That's why it's not revenge, it's avenge.
Mm-hmm.
So Sam Houston, bleeding, needing medical attention, was still able to be cool and calculated and call off the dogs, who all seem to have known somebody at the Alamo and Goliad personally and wanted revenge. And they were, you know, no one could stop this army from gunning down the Mexican army, the Texas army gunning down the Mexican army. And they would be saying, no Goliad, no Alamo.
Right.
But the Texans weren't buying it.
Yeah. Yeah, so many great names, too, come out of all this history as well. And you have illustrations and pictures that are in the book, too. And they are quite stunning when you look through the book. It's Sam Houston and the Alamo Avengers by Brian Kilmeade. And I don't know if you got a chance, Brian. I used to go see Rick Perry at the Governor's Mansion quite a bit. And when you walk in the front door, if you turn to the left, is the sitting area with the original fireplace. And there is where Stephen F. Austin and the Resolute desk of that time, which was nothing more than just one of those kind of like school desks that children had back at that time, where he was writing many of the consequential papers right after all of that happened. It's quite something to see. And the Texas history runs, it's something, man. It's amazing. It's sitting right there in that sitting room just inside the governor's mansion. So all this stuff is just tremendous. And I want to encourage everybody, get the book, the Sam Houston and the Alamo Avengers. You're going to love this read. Brian, I'll let you go. I know you got a million other things to do today. Enjoy your radio show a little bit later on. We'll see you back on TV next week, man.
Yeah, and I'll be on the 17th. I'll be at 1 o'clock at the Keystone School in San Antonio.
Oh, great.
Sign of the book. Tobin Center sold out on the day before, but I hope to see you there. But I'm going to stick around in the afternoon and hopefully see everybody there. We're going to get this story out to the masses. I know you guys live it, but I think it's time for the rest of the country to understand it, and that's my goal.
Amen to that. So the 17th, go see him over at the school, right? Which school is that again?
The Keystone
School. Keystone School, okay.
On Craig Street in San Antonio.
Sounds good. Brian Kilmeade, thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Go get him.
See you soon. Brian Kilmeade from Fox and Friends. And, of course, the book, Sam Houston and the Alamo Avengers. Check it out.